Previously on Vermillion Watch. Behind every sinister incident in London loomed a singular shadow, the Red Queen. With the help of your fellow members, you finally brought her reign to an end. But the light of the full moon lures even more dreadful dangers out of the dark.
This is a strange one indeed, young Hawks. A series of violent incidents such as these suggest both human and animal perpetrators. Impossible, I know. Stranger still, an entire pack of wolves went missing from the London Zoo a few days ago. The two must be connected, and we're here to discover how.
In my travels, I encounter many terrible things, both human and beast. The latter seem to be troubled by high-pitched sounds.
Full moon, Hawks. There's something quite alluring and immensely powerful about it. A primeval source of light that battles the night. This is a busy part of town. It won't be easy to get a fix on the culprit. What is my calling card doing here? Perhaps someone is trying to set me up. We should investigate further. Those prints in the mud must tell a story. unsurprising. Where there is food, you will find crows. Stray foxes have been known to wander into town from time to time. An average-sized men's boot. Not much to go on, I'm afraid. Who would walk around London with bare feet? Then again, there are 6 million people living here. There's bound to be a few odd ducks. Looks like a common pet dog. A bulldog, judging by the size and depth of the prints. This is quite unusual. Seemingly canine in origin, but I wouldn't stake my life on it. Indeed, I've never seen this before. Most of the prints are easily explained, save for the strange wolf-like one. Let's inspect it further. So I was right, in a manner of speaking. It appears the print belongs to a huge wolf in the middle of London. Troubling. What was that? Did you hear it?
The secret to any successful hunt is patience. But I'm tired of waiting for you to show yourself. I knew you'd come back to one of your crime scenes eventually, Mr. Fogg. I take care to study my prey. No, I didn't lure you here. You dropped that calling card yourself when you were here earlier tonight. What a disappointment. After all my hard work, I expected more of a challenge.
Thank you. Previous case, remember? I'm sorry. I didn't know. Run!
Do not be alarmed, my dear. This is my servant, John. I am Dr. Agnes Moreau. You've been infected by a vile disease. Lycanthropy. I'm unsure of its origin, but I do know one thing. Your friend Fogg was the first to be infected. You've been given an inhibitor. It's not a cure, but it will delay your transformation if you take it regularly. Unfortunately, this is all of it. To find a permanent solution, I need Fogg alive. After I extract the antidote, I can cure you both. Not to mention those overgrown wolves. Set a trap for your friend. John will mind the wolves while you stay on the lookout for Allen Quatermain. He wants Fogg dead.
Werewolves.
Destroyed my business, but you won't stop me from catching the ultimate prey. Nothing personal. But you already got Fogg here. You're of no further use to me.
Get away from him, you mangy mutt! And you, Allen, watch where you point that thing! I need him alive!
He's mine, Agnes. Leave now with your feral boy, or I'll have your heads mounted on my wall.
You seem distressed this evening. Mr. Fogg is a werewolf? Then again, considering my lineage, I shouldn't be surprised. Let's see what you found. Where will your investigation take you next? Once the lavish estate of a long-forgotten bloodline, it is now literally sinking into the ground. Take care you don't get pulled down with it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
had another close call, did you? Well, things are not always as they appear. Question everything. Here are all the Vermillion Watch members. One of them must be able to solve this clue.
I'm always happy to help. This was finely crafted. My machine uses light to take precise measurements. Let's take a look. Measurements don't lie. This is but a segment of a larger mechanism.
Where will your investigation take you next? Dr. Moreau is a well-respected biologist and conservationist, known for her numerous African expeditions. Rumor has it, she'd do anything to further her work. Anything.
I'm not surprised to see you here. I expect you want answers, but I have none. We lost Phileas during the confusion, but there's no time to waste. I'm continuing my research with what little resources I have. I do understand your position, though. Feel free to look around. My estate has always been open to public, usually for educational purposes. John will keep an eye. We wouldn't want anything happening to you, would we?
Thank you.
eventually. A bit faster than I hoped, but still just in time. I haven't been completely honest with you, but that matters little now, because I've found the cure. Observe. No, it's having the opposite effect. It's getting bigger. We must evacuate. Wait, don't drink it yet. Use your strength to help us. I have been so rash. I've had that mutated wolf for a while. I thought it would be enough to find the cure. But instead, I lured the pack here. Now John is in trouble. He's strong, but even he can't fight the whole pack. Please, help him. First, we must cure the lake to start up the generator again. In 1872, Allen and I began our sixth African expedition, traveling into the very heart of it. Despite our guide's protest, we made camp in a clearing surrounded by lion statues. Judging by the many footprints and bone offerings, it was a local shrine. But Allen is fearless and always prepared with many guns. Our first few days were fruitful. We filled many cages with specimens. As I catalogued the photos and flower samples we'd gathered that day, I felt eyes upon me. It was just before evening tea time, but African nights are so dark that not even bright stars could ease my mind. Thankfully, many lanterns illuminated our camp. Earlier that day, I noticed some small bite marks on our food supplies. Something had raided our tent. I was nervous, so I lit a cigarette. That morning, we found a wild boy rummaging through our tools. Although feral, he was curious, flipping through my books. Allen threatened to end the boy's life with a blade, claiming he was dangerous and nothing but a wild animal. I managed to stop him by using one of his own nets, regrettably not before he put a knife to the boy's throat. We argued, and Allen, filled with rage, stormed off alone. That didn't end well for him, but that is a story for another time.
Your disease is taking hold. You must hurry. Here are all the Vermillion Watch members. One of them must be able to solve this clue.
I came as fast as I could. We can analyze this metal fragment with acid. That should give us some insight into its origin. From British silver, but the flecks of dirt on it originate from Africa. Fascinating.
Where will your investigation take you next? He was once the best guide in Africa, but his hunting obsession drove him to madness and seclusion. Will you be his next kill?
What's going on out there? But no one would dare trespass. That's it. One more sound, and I'm going out there to silence it myself.
Thank you. Thank you.
my falling out with Agnes. Rage consumed me like a fire. As I roamed the jungle alone, I became paranoid. It felt like even the shadows were after me. Panic overtook me when I noticed deep claw marks surrounding me. For the first time, I felt the presence of mystical spirits. I had encroached on sacred ground. I had never been superstitious, never even religious, until I came face to face with Gino Colli, which means sharp tooth. My foolish pride shattered as the great beast removed my lower jaw in one powerful swipe. Though badly wounded, I stood my ground and killed the beast. Once I realized I had destroyed a god, I realized I could hunt anything. So I did.
attack me. I've killed deadlier creatures than you in my sleep. Wait, is that you? Huh, so you're also infected. I may have underestimated you once, but never again.
Time is running out for you. I can smell it. Here are all the Vermillion Watch members. One of them must be able to solve this clue.
At your service, my friend. Ah, there's a partial maker's seal here. I have an extensive collection of items crafted by British fine jewelers. You'll find what you need here. Now we can clearly see the Maker's seal. He stopped working in 1864.
These parts are drawn to each other. The Earl and Countess Greystoke, a long-forgotten story. They perished in Africa 30 years ago, along with their infant child. Presumed dead, their name and estate soon faded away. It's fascinating how time devours centuries of legacy. However, it appears we were wrong. The child survived. In fact, you've met him. He may yet prove to be your greatest ally in the days to come. I sense him. Far from this city, abandoned trains, chimneys, fire. Agnes Moreau created a waste recycling plant, but it fell into disuse. It seems people have more pressing needs than garbage. You will find them there, all of them.
The last drop of Phileas's blood. I must destroy all traces of my work. No one must be able to make more.
she wanted even more from me. She wanted to control it.
Predictable. I knew early on you wouldn't rest until you saved your friend. Getting my legs back was all that mattered to me. Your friend is weak. I have no more use for him. But you, on the other hand, I think I'll hold on to you. John, lock up our guest. John, what are you doing? Come now, John, don't you see? I needed to borrow your wealth to finance this research. Don't forget, you would have died without me long ago. You may think you're smart, but I've erased the cure from the blackboard. No! Your time is up. I'm sorry for all the havoc I caused around London, but that wasn't really me. You see, my condition granted me immeasurable regenerative powers, but I couldn't control my actions until now. Thanks for not food to the next.
That we've restored the rightful heir to the Greystoke estate. John is even letting the wolf pack stay on his estate. It's not surprising he gave the mansion to them and chose more modest accommodations for himself.
Mission to return poached wildlife to their homes.
We've received word that you discovered an underground menagerie.
I'd like your help to reach it before it's too late. Greetings. I see not much has changed since our last visit to London. The rich get richer and then abuse their power. My men and I are restocking the Nautilus. We'd appreciate your help locating and delivering the animals. Pass through the customs office, get below the bridge and head underground. You'll need light down there.
My men have no part in this. That was the customs officer. I was surprised no one was on call. Careful. Someone is trying to sabotage us, or worse, to lure us.
Once again, my patience pays off. I knew you'd return. I'd rather see this place drown than ever let you have it.
Time is of the essence. We can't stop the leak. This place will flood too fast. We can evacuate the smaller specimens, but I'll entrust the three big ones to you. We must quickly evacuate them according to their water affinity.
Thank you.
While my men were loading the crates, they found this. It looks important. While my men were loading the crates, they found this. It looks important. Once again, you've proven yourself honorable and just. We'll deliver this culprit to the nearest jail. Farewell.